Settle on. Salam. Ya haba shima shabakata. You gonna kick it off tonight?
Khan, so first, I wanna give all praise, glory, and honor to Yahweh Shah, Hashem, Rakah, the Dash. Thanks all belonging to the elders of the Apostle Great Millstone that do rule well. I'm the brother Tamayim.
Brother Kabar.
Brother Yitzhazaka.
Spirit and power, Yahweh Shemesh. I just want to do a short little lesson about repentance and how then repentance is, amen. If you don't repent, you're going to die, basically. You know? Let me go get this scripture. Nay, unless you repent, you shall all likewise. This is Luke chapter 13, verse 3. It says, I tell you, nay, but except ye repent, ye shall all likewise perish. You know, and that word repent means to turn back sorrowfully to the God in the Bible, you know what I'm saying, about all the wrong that you've done, and, you know, try to the best of your ability to keep his law, touch commandments during this grace period.
That was Luke 13.
Luke 13 and 3. You know, so if we don't repent, you know what I'm saying? Repentance is a commandment. It's not up for debate or anything of that nature. You know what I'm saying? This is a commandment from the Heavenly Father that we repent. You know what I'm saying? Otherwise, we're going to perish, man. And repentance is not something that you can do, just say, oh, I have repented. And no, this is a daily thing. You know, this is a every second of the day thing. This is a hour to hour, minute to minute thing, man. You know?
Matter of fact, you in the blue letter?
I got the blue letter.
Might as well look that word repentance up.
Luke 13 and 3, right? It says repent. Metaneo. It says to change one's mind. It says to repent. It says to change one's mind for better. Heartily amend with abhorrence of one's past sins. It says heartily to amend with abhorrence of one's past sins, man. And we know abhor means to be in disgust, man. To hate, you know what I'm saying? Your past sins, to change, man. It says to think differently or afterwards reconsider morally, you know what I'm saying, to feel compunction. It says to feel sorry that one has done this or that, have offended someone. That's pretty much the point. It says, so you know what I'm saying, turn back softly to the God in the Bible. You know, because we've all sinned. So we all meet for the requirements, you know what I'm saying, for repentance, man. You brothers got any scriptures?
I got a couple. You got something, Kabar?
Yeah. You, Brian, what you got?
You can go first, because I got a couple I want to grab.
Just land back the point you had. This is in the 2 Corinthians chapter 4 and verse 16. It says, for which cause we faint not, but though our outward man perish, yet the inward man is renewed day by day. So every day we need to be renewed, you know, be renewed and repent. You know, I get that. But ultimately, you know what I'm saying? It's a daily thing, man. You know, it's not something that you do just one time, man. Every day we need to be renewed, man. Every day we need to examine ourselves and make sure that we're in the faith, you know, and avoid a judgment. I was also going to get this as Ezekiel, because you get that word repent. In this verse here, I'm going to just get this. It's Ezekiel 14 and verse Okay, this is Ezekiel 14 in verse 6. It says, therefore, say unto the house of Israel, thus said the Lord Yahweh, repent and turn yourselves from your idols and turn away your faces from all your abominations. So I want to get the blue light on that, because that word repent in this verse here, right? Strong's H7725. It says to return, turn back, to turn back, return. You know? So to turn back, man. To turn back to the Most High, man. You know? And ultimately, what does that mean, man? We're given the law, statutes, and commandments. You know? So you have to turn back, all right, into following the ways of our power, man. The Most High was only dealing with the children of Israel. You know? Because you know that word re. You know? If you get that word re, something is happening again. You know? So what are you doing again? You're going back into the Most High, when the Most High created man, you know, in the image, you know, in Genesis 1:26, that's going back into that order, man, that the Most High created for the man, for the sons of God, man, which are the Israelites. That was it.
Okay, I got this right here. This is Ephesians chapter 4. In verse 21, it says, if so be that ye have heard him and have been taught by him as the truth and is in Yahweh Shai, that ye put off concerning the former conversation, the old man, which is corrupt according to the deceitful lust, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind, and that ye put on the new man, which is after Yahweh by Shem Yahweh Shai, created in righteousness and true holiness, you know, and that's repentance right there. That's repenting, man. You know, that's changing one's mind. That's being sorrowful about what you have done. That's turning back, you know. That's making a concerned effort to make a change, man. That's what true repentance is, man. When you truly repent, you know, you're not the same person no more. You're not doing the same things that you once were no more, you know? And, you know, like, I'm trying to think what it was. I had thought about something earlier, you know what I'm saying? It was like a nigga thought, you know what I'm saying? I can't remember exactly what it was, but I was like, I had to check myself, you know what I'm saying? I had to check myself, like, no, that's not me no more. I don't do that type of stuff no more, you know? I don't think like that no more, you know? That's true repentance, man. You know, you turn away from how you was, you change your mind and your thinking, and you don't do that no more. You don't think like that no more. You know, that's true. That's true repentance right there, you know. And I got one more scripture to back up to mine was saying, because, you know, he made a good point that repentance is a commandment. You're commanded by Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai to repent. This ain't just no... This ain't just no, you know, the Lord requires us to repent. You know, it's a commandment. This ain't just no choice. You don't have no choice. The Lord commands us to repent. You know, this is Acts chapter 17, verse 30. In the times of this ignorance, Yahweh by Shem Yahweh Shai winked at, but now command of all men everywhere to repent. So just like Samayim said, he command of all men everywhere to repent, man. It was a time where Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai was winking at the ignorance. He was overlooking it, you know. But now Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, he's not overlooking ignorance no more. You know, you have to turn away from ignorance, all right, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind, you know, be a new man, put off that old man, you know, and do what Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai requires of you, you know.
Come on, bro. Very powerful point. Wow. 2 Corinthians 5:17, it says, therefore, if any man be in the Mashiach, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. You know, like the brother was going into, you know what I'm saying? You don't do that no more. Well, that's true repentance, man. Because the old things, all right, that's all corrupt. You know what I'm saying? That's all deceitful lust. Those are the things of the world. You know what I'm saying? Repentance is putting off those things. And coming into this, you know, what's good and pleasing to Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. I want to want to bring this out. This is Isaiah 55 and 6. It says, "Seek ye the Lord, Yahweh, while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return unto the Lord, and he will have mercy upon him, and to our power, for he will abundantly pardon." So, you know, Yahweh Shemashah is not unrighteous. You know what I mean? He's saying, he'll give you a chance if you turn from your unrighteous thoughts and your wicked ways, man. You know what I'm saying? Then the Lord will have mercy upon us. And that's why it's so important that we repent, especially at this time more now than ever before, like Doc was going into. You know what I'm saying? The Lord winked at it, but he's commanded us to repent. You know what I'm saying? And that's why we got to turn away from this wickedness, man, in order to receive mercy from Yahweh Shemashah, because the Lord's not giving out mercy like candy, and like something that's free, man. You got to work for that mercy, man. You got to put some effort in there to receive mercy, man. True repentance.
Mm-hmm. True repentance, man. You know? Because the wicked, they could seem like they repenting, but they ain't truly repenting, man. You have to truly repent, man, to get that mercy.
Yep, something for a favor for a favor. Well, which really is, this is your duty to do anyways, you know?
Mm-hmm. You got something, bro?
Yeah, I'm gonna get with that brother. Just posted on the comment board. I'm gonna get that. This Matthew chapter 4 verse 17. It says, "From that time Yahweh began to preach and to say, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand." You know, so that's what our Lord Yahweh was all about. Man, he was all about repentance, man. You know, that was our Lord. He pushed it, man. He was heavy into repentance, man. You know, that was big, man. You know, and that's what all the followers of Yahweh Shah pushed, you know, was repentance. You know, repentance what? In the name of Yahweh Shah, you know, in the name of Yahweh Shah, that brings forth repentance, man. All right, and the kingdom of heaven is at hand. So now it's time for, you know, us to cut that bull BS out, man, you know, and get for real, man, because, you know, like it says, there's no wisdom in the grave, man, where thou goest. You know, you ain't gonna turn. You ain't gonna turn then. You know, scriptures say they shall teach no more his neighbor. You know, so in the kingdom of heaven, it's you. We just gonna be already on go. The law, statutes, commandments is gonna be on our inward parts. It ain't gonna be. We're not gonna have to repent no more. You know, we're not gonna have to turn back because we're gonna be right completely. This is the time for us to turn back right now. You know, but I got this too. This Ezekiel chapter 33 verse 11. It says, "Say unto them, as I live, said the Lord Yahweh Shemashah, I have no pleasure in the death of the wicked, but that the wicked turn from his way and live. Turn ye from your evil ways, for why will ye die, O house of Israel?" You know, so Yahweh Shemashah, he ain't trying to kill nobody out here. You know, yeah, we going to how the Heavenly Father is real harsh out here. He's the King of Terrors. You know, El Shaddai. You know, we going to, you know, the Lord's judgment. You know, how the Lord ain't nothing to play with. You know, we touch on that, you know, a lot. You know, but the Lord, you know, like I tell you in Sirach 16, as his judgment is, so is his mercy. You know, so the Lord is he'll put forth judgment, but he also is merciful as well, man. You know, so the Lord, he will pardon you, like the brother brought up in Isaiah 55. You know, the Lord don't want to kill you, man. All right, but if you don't want to turn from your wicked ways, you leave him no choice, man. You leave him no choice but to kill you. You know, and that go to that word turn. Turning back, like the brother Kabar brought out, you know, in Ezekiel. I'm not sure what chapter that was. What chapter that was?
I believe that was 14.
Yeah, Ezekiel the 14th chapter. You know, it said to turn back. You know, so it's telling you right here, turn ye from your evil ways. That's turning back. That's repenting, man. All right. For why would ye die, O house of Israel? You know, Because we know if the Lord's commanding you to repent, you can't break no commandments out here just willingly. You're gonna get knocked off. Like the scriptures say, those who broke the law of Moses, you know what I'm saying, got killed in front of two or three witnesses, man. You know? So we're still under the law of Moses, man. You know, even though we're not saved by the law, but you gotta come back to full obedience to the best of your abilities, man, or you're gonna get knocked off out here, you know.
God, powerful point, man. Powerful point. You know, I want to go get this. This is Isaiah 1 and 16. It says, wash you, make you clean, put away the evil of your doings from before mine eyes, cease to do evil. You know? And, you know what I'm saying? Of course, this word is what washes you. This word is what makes you clean. You know what I'm saying? But the Lord, this is repentance, putting away the evil of your doing before mine eyes, because the Lord has to see all of that, man. The Lord don't want to see that. The ones that's doing that, he going to destroy them, man. What is that? Fret not thyself because of evildoers that prospers in his way. They shall soon be cut off as the grass. You know? It says, cease to do evil. It says, learn to do well. Seek judgment. Relieve the oppressed. Judge the fatherless. Plead for the widow. You know, ultimately, you know what I'm saying, like, this is repentance, you know, putting away the evil of your doings, man, with wickedness, man. And we know we live in a wicked world, you know what I'm saying? But ultimately, hey, man, what does the scripture say? When I was a child, I speak as a child, but when I became a man, I put away childish things, man. Mm-hmm. That's why they call Esau the child in the scriptures, the younger man, because he's wicked, man. And that stuff is just like, you know what I'm saying? That wickedness is like immaturity, like children stuff, man. You know what I'm saying? This is why we have to show ourselves as men, you know? By repentance. It's lucky.
Mm-hmm. You got some, brother?
Yeah, a few. Second Chronicles 7 and verse 14, it says, if my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land. You know? So, amen. Of course, it's talking about the Israelites, man. We know sin was only given to Israel, but ultimately it says, turn from their wicked ways, man. And then it says, then I will hear from heaven. So Most High hearing praise of the wicked, we know that in the book of Proverbs 29th chapter. We understand that, hey man. This thing is about coming back into these Lord Sessions commandments, understanding, believing the gospel, which I had that in Mark 1. But ultimately, when you house shot based, let me just get it to lock here. Because it was Mark 1 and 14, it says, now after that John was put in prison, Yehoshua came to Galilee preaching the gospel of the kingdom of the Most High, and saying, the time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of the Most High is at hand. Repent ye and believe the gospel. You know? So it's about repentance, man. It's about being a true believer, man. If you have faith that you're about to get delivered out of here, if you understand that these Edomites, starting with these Lee Baker families, they're going to head for some captivity, then we're going to repent. We're going to make sure that we're trying to get up out of here. So we're going to follow suit. How do we do that? By repenting.
There's so much that comes with repentance, like Doc was going into. This is really your last time to lay up your treasures in heaven. You know what I'm saying? Scriptures say, he that doeth the will of my Father, same shall be called great in the kingdom. We have to teach each other. You know what I'm saying? Like, we're going to have it. We're going to be on goal, like the brother said. You know? So it's a very serious thing. It's a very courageous thing, too, man. It's a very brave thing. You know what I'm saying? To repent fully and wholeheartedly. I had this over here. If you got anything, if you don't got anything,
go ahead, bro.
Rock 21 and 1 says, my son, hast thou sinned? Do so no more. But for thy former sins, you know. So yeah, we're gonna fall sometimes in this thing, but you don't wanna fall completely. You know what I'm saying? And you wanna repent, right? it says ask pardon for thy former sins. You know, you gotta you can't cover your sins, man. As a matter of fact, this is Proverbs 28:13. It says, he that covereth his sins shall not prosper, but whoso confesseth and forsaketh them shall have mercy. So first it's confessing and then it's forsaking, you know what I'm saying, and putting it away, you know. The Lord, every time he tells you to confess it, you know, he tells you to put it away, man. You know, like it says, my son, hast thou sinned, do so no more, but ask pardon for thy former sins. It says, flee from sin as from the face of a serpent, for if thou comest too near it, it will bite thee. The teeth thereof are the teeth of lions, slaying the souls of men. Mm. All iniquity is as a two-edged sword. The wound thereof cannot be healed. So, hey, man, you know, iniquity, sin, that's like a weapon, man. It'll kill you, man. It's a two-edged sword, man. You get put to death for doing that, man. You know, and it's very serious, man. This is the spiritual battle we're fighting out here, man. You know, and that's why it's so important that we repent, you know what I'm saying, being more of a lowly state. Because the Lord, you know what I'm saying, this sin is a foolish thought, man. Scripture tell you that sin is a foolish thought, man. You know, and that's why we want to have, you know what I'm saying, the mind of Yahweh Shemal Shah. It's lucky.
Yep. Beautiful. Beautiful. That was a beautiful passage you just pulled up. Let me get this. This 1 Peter chapter 4, and I start from the top. This 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 1, for as much then as Hamashiach have suffered for us in the flesh, arm yourself likewise with the same mind. For he that have suffered in the flesh have ceased from sin. You know, so that's what it's all about, man. You know, us putting on the mind of Yahweh Shah, man. And what did Yahweh Shah do, you know? Well, he ceased from sin, you know. That's suffering. That's which is what's required of you, you know, which is what's required of you. And it says, you know, it says, for as much as Hamashiach have suffered for us in the flesh, arm yourself likewise with the same mind. That's that repentance, man. Change your mind, man. You know, changing from the way you think, man. You know, living according to how our Lord would want us to live, you know. You know, it says, for he that have suffered in the flesh have ceased from sin. So once you suffer in the flesh, it causes you to cease from sin. That's how you truly repent, because you're suffering. You know, you're not allowing yourself to do certain things. That's repentance. You know, it says that he no longer shall live the rest of his time in the flesh to the lust of man, but to the will of Yahweh Shemal Shai. That's repentance, man. You know, you suffering as our Lord Yahweh Shai did, you know, arming your mind with that same mind to suffer, you know, so you don't have to live your life no more according to the flesh and the lust of man, you know, but to the will of Yahweh Shemal Shai. That's why it says in Galatians, the fifth chapter, you know, pretty much if you're in the spirit, you're not under the law, you know, because if you're in the spirit, you're going to be moving according to the law. You know, there's one and the same. You know, it says, for the time past of our life may suffice us to write the will of the Gentiles when we walk in lasciviousness, lust, excess of wine, revelings, banquetings, and abominable idolatries, wherein they think it strange that ye run not with them in the same excess of riot, speaking evil of you. You know, because you'll have people that talk shit about you, you know, because you're not living, you're not being the same guy that you used to be in the world, man. You know, so they'll talk mess about you, man. You know, basically saying, oh, like, oh, you think you use that same nigga doing this a couple years ago, man. I remember when you was doing this and that, man. You know, man, you ain't no real man of the Lord. You know, it says, who shall give account to him that is ready to judge the quick and the dead? It says, for this cause was the gospel preached also to them that are dead, that they might be judged according to the man of flesh, but live according to Yahweh Bashim Yahshua in the spirit. So that's the whole point of that. You know, Yahweh Bashim Yahshua requires that that's the humility, you know, being humiliated, you know, being looked at. You get judged in the flesh, you know, but but when Yahweh Shah comes, you're gonna be judged according to your spirit, man. You know, because your spirit is what allows you to be able to defeat the former man that you was, you know, defeat the flesh. You know, that's true repentance when you come into the spirit, you know. But I got this one right here too. This Romans chapter 12, verse 1, it says, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of Yahweh Bashim Yahshua, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto Yahweh, which is your reasonable service. You know, because Yahweh Bashim Yahshua, he said he requires you doing, hold on, let's just get it. It's like you. My fault. Let's just get it on. Butcher it. It's in I'm gonna go here. It's Second Samuel chapter 15 and verse 23 or 23? No, it's First Samuel. So like your First Samuel 15, verse 15 and 23. 24, Salakia. This First Samuel 15 and 22, Salakia. This First Samuel 15 and 22. And Samuel said, have the Lord Yahweh Bashim Yahshua as great delight in burnt offerings and sacrifices as in obeying the voice of the Lord Yahweh Bashim Yahshua. Behold, to obey is better than sacrifice, and to hearken than the fat of rams. You know, so obeying, you know, which, you know, obeying the will of Yahweh Bashim Yahshua, living to the will of Yahweh Bashim Yahshua, is better than sacrifice. That's your true sacrifice. That's repentance right there, you know. So, you know, that's the sacrifice that's acceptable unto Yahweh Bashim Yahshua. You repenting, you know. It says, and be not conformed to this world, back in Romans 12 and 2, Selachia, back in Romans 12 and 2, and be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of Yahweh Bashim Yahshua. You know, that's when you renew your mind, that's that repentance. That's what Yahweh Bashim Yahshua is looking for, man. You know, when you renew your mind and start living according to the will of Yahweh Bashim Yahshua, which is not being a part of the flesh, you know, putting away the flesh. You know, that's what proves what Yahweh Bashim Yahshua requires for you, you know. Yeah, you brothers got it.
Point, man. You got anything? Yeah, made me think of this scripture. First Peter chapter 1, verse 7. It says, faith being much more precious than of gold that perisheth, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Mashiach Yahushua. You know, because like you're saying, he that suffered in the flesh have ceased from sin. So this is actually a trial. This is actually how we are being made more precious to find gold, is by repenting to Yahweh Bashim Yahshua and fighting off the things of the flesh and the lust of the flesh and in the world. You know what I'm saying? This is actually how we are being made more precious to find gold through the furnace of adversity and affliction, man. You know, trying to be a righteous man in the most wicked kingdom that ever existed in the scriptures.
That's what's acceptable, you know. That's what's acceptable. That's that, just that goal, you know. That fine gold, you know.
God. And you know, gold holds weight.
God. yep. That's a good point. Yep.
It's a lot. I also wanted to get this right here in Acts, the 3rd chapter, verse 19. It says, repent ye therefore and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out when the refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. You know, so that your sins may be blotted out. You know what I'm saying? You want to be on deck when the Lord returns. You want to be without spot, blameless, with no guile found in your mouth. You know what I'm saying? There's no way the Lord's going to accept you if you're not, if you haven't fully repented. That's why, you know, he was going into scripture about leaven and the Passover and how a little leaven leaveneth the whole lump. And you know what I'm saying? You want to put away all of that foolishness, man, the wickedness of this world, you know what I'm saying? The lust of the flesh, you know? Scripture tell you, mortify thy members, you know what I'm saying? So ultimately, if we do these things, you know what I'm saying, our sins will be blotted out at the times of refreshing when the Lord, man. And that's a beautiful thing. What more? That's the highest honor that you could ever have in existence. All for a little repentance, you get the highest and highest honor in existence, man.
Mm-hmm. Got something for work?
Let me get this. This is Joel chapter 2. Yeah, let me get Joel 2 and 12. It says, therefore also now, saith the Lord Yahweh, turn ye even to me with all your heart, and with fasting and weeping and mourning, and rend your heart, and not your garments, and turn unto the Lord Yahweh your power, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, and of great kindness, and repenteth him of the evil. You know? So ultimately, you know, scriptures talk about letting out your sins weighing you down. Most High, he's going to have mercy on who he has mercy on, man. You know, and then there's certain accounts of, you know, like King David, like bringing that up, because that's hopefully elect, man, the house of David, you know, the Bayat Avodah, you know. So ultimately understanding that, hey, man, you know what I'm saying? Don't be weighed down. Don't let that cause you to doubt. Like, you know, the Most High ain't dealing with me, you know. Hey, man, ultimately, scriptures talk about, you know, it's going to cause particular wicked men to go into mischief, you know. You know, right, the just man fall down 7 times, but he rise up again, you know.
Yeah, scripture talks about how, you know, the righteous or the just, they, matter of fact, this is Psalms 37 and 24. It says, though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast down, for the Lord upholdeth him with his hand, you know. So, you know what I'm saying? There's going to be times you have slips and falls, man. But if you predestinated from the foundation of the earth, you're going to go hard. You're going to keep these laws, man. You know what I'm saying? And ultimately, you're going to get saved out of this place, man.
You got something, bro?
Yeah, I got a couple on. It's Matthew chapter 9 and verse 12. But when Yahweh Shai heard that, he said unto them that they that be whole need not a physician, but they that are sick. So that's the whole point, man. That's the whole point. Well, let's get this real quick. Let's get this. Hold on. Let's get this. This, 1 Timothy is one of my favorite scriptures right here. It's about you. 1 Timothy.
Okay. Oh,
we're running out of time already?
I probably got at least 20.
Oh, okay, kind. It's a lot. Brother, you'll grab 1 Timothy 1 and 9 for me, Baba Kishaw?
Timothy 1?
Yeah, 1 Timothy 1 and 9.
1 Timothy chapter 1 and verse 9, it says, knowing this, that the law is not made for a righteous man, but for the
law. Right, so the law is not made for a righteous man, you know? That's the whole point. The law was made for you to be brought back unto it, you know? The law was made for you to know how to live, man. You know, basically, you're not supposed to, like, get shot down where you be like, okay, I've committed iniquity and now I'm finished, you know? That's what the law is for, man. It wasn't made for a righteous man, you know? Just like it said in Matthew 9 and 12, it says, they that be whole or not need of a physician, you know? So we're not whole, man. We're not whole. We need a physician, you know, which, you know, that comes forth with repentance. That's you repenting, you know. That's your healing process, you know, because ultimately you repent until you don't have to repent no more, you know.
Yep. God.
It's some more on that, right?
You got more? It's lucky.
Con. This is It says, knowing this, that the law is not made for a righteous man, but for the lawless and disobedient, for the ungodly and for sinners, for unholy and profane, for murderers of fathers and murderers of mothers, for manslayers, for whoremongers, for them that defile themselves with mankind, for men stealers, for liars, for perjured persons. In Saki, it says, and if there be any other thing that is contrary to sound doctrine.
Kind, bro. You see, so that's, you pretty much, you can come back from anything, man. When I read that, I heard it said that those who defile themselves with mankind, I was like, damn, a sodomite can come back. You know what I'm saying? You could be a sodomite and repent, man. You know, that's what this law was made for. It was made for those to repent and turn from their wickedness, man. All those, anybody who's involved in any type of level of wickedness to turn from it, you know, which is repentance. That's what this is all about, you know. But let me read this in Matthew 9 again. This is Matthew 9 and 12. It says, but when Yahushua heard that, he said unto them, they that be whole need not a physician, but they that are sick. It says, but go ye and learn what that meaneth. I will have mercy and not sacrifice, for I am not come to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance. So that's who Yahushua came to call. Man, came to call sinners to repentance, man. All right. He didn't come to call those who already got it already. You know, he came to call those who gonna hear it and change from what they doing and get right. That's the whole point of our Lord Yahushua. You know, that's why he suffered in the flesh for us, so we could suffer in the flesh, putting off that old man, you know, and be renewed, you know, be made new. Renewed means to be made new, be refreshed, you know, and that's what we're going to be, you know, what, like, to mind was touching on not being found with no guile, like in Revelation the 14th chapter. That's when you completely renewed and refreshed, you know. But I got a couple more. Oh, you had something to say? Oh, it's a lot.
I was going to say, like, you know what I'm saying, when you talk about renewing and refreshing, you know what I'm saying, you have to realize that, you know what I'm saying, something's dirty. Like, you know what I'm saying, if your kitchen is dirty, obviously you see it, you know what I'm saying, then first you have to acknowledge, you know what I'm saying, what the problem is. And then once you acknowledge it, then you could correct it. You know what I'm saying? That's the scripture talk about. I was going to bring this out real quick.
Go ahead, bro.
This is 1 John 1 and 8. It says, if we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. So ultimately, repentance is, this is a life of repentance, straight up. You know what I'm saying? The life that we live in out here, this is a whole life of repentance. You know what I'm saying? Because we all got sin in us. You know what I'm saying? It says, verse 9, it says, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So, like I was saying, you have to confess your sins, man. You have to confess your faults. You know what I'm saying? Like, whatever it may be, man. You know what I'm saying? The Lord is not saying, don't tell me. You know what I mean? Don't, you know what I'm saying? When you have your me time with the Lord, you got to just tell him. Tell him. You know what I'm saying? Like, it says, and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. If we say that we have not sinned, we make him a liar, and his word is not in us, man. Mm. So, and that's pretty much the point I was trying to bring out. It's a lot.
Yeah. You got something, Kabar?
Yeah, I have one real quick, just to land back what you were saying. This is in Hebrews 6, in verse 6.
Mm.
It says, if they shall fall away, to renew them again into repentance, seeing they crucified to themselves the Son of the Most High afresh, it says, and put him to an open shame. You know, see, this is what we're talking about, man. Being renewed, right? Being refreshed. I'm going to just jump down to 9. It says, but beloved, we are persuaded better things of you and things that accompany salvation, though we thus speak, you know? So particular men, all right, who believe, man, who believe that he is, that believe that he's a warrior and that diligently seek him, they're gonna repent. Lord willing, widows, man, we're gonna repent, like the brothers bringing out every day, man. For this whole life that we're in the sinful flesh, we're gonna just continue to be renewed, Lord willing. You know? Yeah, that was it.
Yeah. That script you was bringing out where you said, Though our outward man perish, our inward man is renewed day by day.
Mm-hmm.
Repentance.
Shalom. Oh, yeah, but she must have
Shalom.
I got this. This Psalms 32:1. It says, blessed is he whose transgression is forgiven, whose sin is covered. Blessed is the man unto whom the Lord Yahweh Shemashah imputeth not iniquity, and in whose spirit there is no guile. You know, in whose spirit there is no guile, man. That's what it's about, man, having that fresh spirit, man. You know, this flesh is through, man. This flesh is through. I mean, but that don't mean you just abuse it. You know what I'm saying? Like, you just trash it just because it's through. You know, once you learn about this truth, the things that you have done in your flesh, you know, you can't take that back now. But, you know, you still uphold it now, you know. And that's having that right spirit. That's not having no guile in your spirit. Just recognizing, like, okay, yeah, I've done things that were, you know, filthy in his flesh, you know, but I'm gonna uphold myself to the best standard in my spirit, you know, and I'm not gonna continue to abuse my flesh, you know, with filthiness, you know. Let me get this real quick too. This is let me get this. Let me start right here. This Psalms 34:16. It says, the face of the Lord Yahweh Shemashah is against them that do evil, to cut off the remembrance of them from the earth. Yeah. So just like it tell you in Amos the 9th chapter, you know what I'm saying? When it say all the sinners of my people should die by the sword, you know, Yahweh Shemashah, you know, what it say, Amos 9:9-8, it says, the eyes of the Lord are upon the sinful kingdom, and I will destroy it from off the face of the earth, man. You know, and that sinful kingdom really going into the nation of Israel, man. You know, that's really what it's touching on, you know. So Yahweh Shemashah is against all those who commit evil and iniquity, you know. It says, the righteous cry in the Lord, Yahweh Shemashah, heareth and delivereth them out of all their troubles. The Lord, Yahweh Shemashah, is nigh unto them that are of a broken heart, and save of such as a contrite spirit, you know. So you get that word contrite, Baba Kasha, in Psalms 34:18, because it says, the Lord, Yahweh Shemashah, is nigh unto them who of a broken heart. Like their definition for repent that Tamim brought out, it was touching on being sorrowful, you know what I'm saying? So if you're sorrowful, you got a broken heart, and the scriptures speak about godly sorrow worketh repentance, you know. So that godly sorrow, man, feeling you know, bad about the things that you have done in your flesh, man, you know, the transgressions that you have committed towards the Yahweh Shemashah, that's a part of your repentance, man. And if you truly feel bad about it, you're gonna do something about it, which means you're not gonna continue to indulge in those type of things, you know. And the Lord, he honors that, you know. He's nigh unto you for that, you know.
God, I got a, it's the Dekah, H 1792. It says, crushed, you know, contrite, crushed, intensive. It says, very much crushed, broken, very small. Broken in spirit, cast down, turn man to dust.
Gosh. So you lowly, man. You know, you real low, man. That's why I tell you what, Psalms 138:6, you know, the Lord Yahweh Shemashah be on high, he have respect unto the lowly, you know. So Yahweh Shemashah requires you to be low, man. If you should be crushed, you know, we should all be crushed, man. You know, we have done things worthy of death, man. You know, you should be crushed and brokenhearted about that, man. You know, and guess what? That's what the Lord wants from you, man. You know, because that's true repentance. It's true repentance. But yeah, that was it. That was it. You brothers got something?
Yeah.
This is in Ezekiel 18 and 30. It says, therefore, I will judge you, O house of Israel, everyone according to his ways, said the Lord Yahweh. It says, repent and turn yourselves from all your transgressions, so iniquity shall not be your ruin. You got it, bro.
God, what precept that was up?
That was Ezekiel 18 and 30.
You'll read it one more time, Bible Kishore.
Therefore, I will judge you, O house of Israel, everyone according to his ways, said the Lord Yahweh. It says, repent and turn yourselves from all your transgressions, so iniquity shall not be your ruin.
Yeah, because they tell you in Proverbs the 8th chapter, he that sinneth against me wrongeth his own soul. You know what I'm saying? So basically, you know, it's on you, man. You know, what you gonna continue to indulge yourself in wickedness, man, and not turn from it, then that's you just pretty much committing suicide. Like you speak about in Second Peter, the second chapter, the brother Kabar always pulled it out, you know, about you know, yeah, as natural brute beasts, you know, who are gonna utterly, you know, utterly, what it say about how it go out? Might as well pull it. Utterly perish in their own corruption. Con. You can still pull it though if you want.
Second Peter 2:12, it says, that these as natural brute beasts made to be taken and destroyed, speak evil of the things that they understand not, and shall utterly perish in their own corruption.
Yeah, you committing suicide, man. That's suicide, you know. Basically continuing to continue on in your wickedness, man, and not turn from it. That's suicide, man. You're gonna utterly perish in your own corruption, man. You know, but just like we brought out in Ezekiel 33, why do that? Why shall ye die, O Israel? You know, turn ye from your evil ways and you're gonna live. You know. But what it say, all those that hate me love death, you know. And you hate the Lord if you don't feel sorry for the things that you've done in your life, you gotta hate the Lord, man. You're sick, you know. You don't love the Lord, man, you know. And the Lord is not nigh unto you. He's gonna destroy your ass.
Yep.
God, I got that script, though. Proverbs 8:36, but he that sinneth against me wrongeth his own soul. All that hate me love death.
Yeah, that's it right there, man. You know, if you hate the Lord, how do you hate the Lord? Because you refuse to you refuse to accept accountability for your actions, man. You know, what it say in Proverbs 30:20? Such is the way of an adulterous woman. She wipeth her mouth and say she have done no wickedness, man. You know, and we know that Israel is likened unto a comely and delicate woman, man. You know, so you just basically just like a slut freak who had a husband just been going out doing all type of sick perverseness, man. You know, and you don't want to acknowledge it, man. You don't want to accept no accountability for that, man. You know, yeah, no shame, man. You know, you must hate your husband, man. Which the Heavenly Father is the husband, man. You know, so you hate the Lord, man. You know, and guess what? You gonna die for that. You're going to die. All those that hate me love death. You know? So if you hate
following the way of Yahweh Hashim Yahshua, turning back unto the way of Yahweh Hashim Yahshua, guess what? You love death. You know?
Mm-hmm. Yep. You know, hey, man, sin's transgression of the law. The wages of sin, death.
I got me thinking of,
Yeah,
pain
by death.
Yeah, man.
Yep.
It says, 2 Kings 9:9. It says, then shall they be in the pitiful case which have not abused my ways, and they that have cast them away despitefully shall dwell in torments. For such as in their life have received benefits and have not known me, and they that have loathed my law while they had yet liberty, and when as yet place of repentance was open unto them, understood it not, but despised it. The same must know it after death by pain. You know what I'm saying? Those that hate me love death. You're right, man. You know, that's what the Lord's precept upon precept, man. You know, now you're not repenting. It says when repentance is open unto you, you got all of the liberty, all of the freedom to turn back to Yahweh Shemesh. The scriptures say, make no tarry to turn to the Lord, or in thy security thou shalt be destroyed and perish in the day of vengeance. You know? So, hey, like I was trying to say earlier, repentance is a commandment. Otherwise, you're going to get put to death, man.
That's it.
You know? But, and this is what happens when you repent. This Exodus 34 and 6, it says, and the Lord Yahweh passed by before him and proclaimed, the Lord Yahweh, the Lord thy power, merciful and gracious, long-suffering and abundant in goodness and truth, keeping mercy for thousands, forgiving iniquity and transgression and sin, and that will by no means clear the guilty, visit iniquity of the fathers upon the children and upon the children's children unto the fourth generation. Hashem is very merciful, but he's not going to clear the guilty, though. You know what I'm saying? But that's why repentance is so important, man. So you can appear as, you know what I'm saying, innocent, without guile. You know what I'm saying? Blameless, spotless. You wanna be clean, man. You wanna appear clean before the mediator, because Lord Yahusha is the only one gonna get you up in there. You know what I'm saying? So, hey, man, repentance. You don't repent, you get put to death, man.
Straight up.
Straight up. Who we doing it?
Just to land back, because you had brought out 2 Ezra 9, where it talks about they loathed thy law while they had liberty. This is in 2 Peter, 1 Peter chapter 1, and I'm going to start at 15. It says, for so is the will of the Most High. It says, that with well-doing ye may put to silence the ignorance of foolish men. It says, verse 16, as free and not using your liberty for a cloak of maliciousness, that's certainly most high. You got it, bro.
Yeah, you got some martial art.
You don't want to use your liberty as a cloak of maliciousness, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, we got the ability and the freedom to serve Yahweh Shemesh Shai wholeheartedly, 100%. All right, the Lord ain't no freebies out here, man. You know?
That's the spirit. I got a lesson called that Yahweh Shemesh Shai ain't giving out no freebies out here. That's the spirit.
You know, like, that sounds powerful.
Yeah, like what you thought the Lord was just, you know what I'm saying?
Some, like Oprah?
You know what I'm saying? You know, the Lord was kind of some puppet or something, man. Like you on his strings or some shit.
Right.
I mean, he on your strings.
Like you getting something for nothing out here?
Good. No, that's definitely not how it works. Oh, I got some. This This Isaiah 66 and 1. Thus saith the Lord Yahweh Shemesh Shai, the heaven is my throne and the earth is my footstool. Where is the house that ye built unto me, and where is the place of my rest? So Yahweh Shemesh Shai saying, well, the earth, you know, the heaven is my throne, the earth is my footstool. So, you know, what kind of house you going to build for me? It says, which we know that we are the house of the Lord. You know, our bodies is a temple of the Most High. But to keep going, it says, for all those things have mine hand made, and all those things have been, said the Lord Yahweh Shemesh Shai. But to this man will I look, even to him that is poor and of a contrite spirit, and trembleth at my word. You know, so that's the place where Yahweh Shemesh Shai is going to rest at, man. You know. Psalms 34 and 18 again, you know, the Lord is nigh unto them who are of a contrite spirit, man. So that's what the Lord is resting and dwelling. You know, that's who the Lord is resting with and who he's dwelling with. You know, those who are of a contrite spirit, man, and trembleth at his word, man. You know, because if you're supposed to hear this and you're supposed to get sorrowful and be like, damn, bro, the Lord. That like that script you brought out in 2 Ezra, the 9th chapter. You know, you receive benefits and have not known me. You have loathed my law. The same must know it after death by pain and dwelling in torments, man. You're supposed to tremble at that, man. Like, damn, bro, I've been doing this and that against the Lord. You know what I'm saying? Like, man, I'm sorrowful about it, man. And he's worthy of giving me death by pain, you know. But to keep going, But that's what the Lord respects. That's their true repentance. You know, it says, he that killeth an ox is as if he slew a man. He that sacrificeth a lamb as if he cut off a dog's neck. He that offereth an oblation as if he offered swine's blood. He that burneth incense as if he blessed the idol. Yeah, they have chosen their own ways, and their soul delighteth in their abominations. Yeah, so you doing these things like, pretty much like, you know, because people do all type of wickedness and say they serving the Lord. Yeah, about Shimei Shai. You know, the Lord is not accepting no blemish sacrifice, man. I think that's in the book of Deuteronomy, the 17th chapter, I think. You know, if I'm not mistaken, the Lord don't accept no, you can't bring no spotted or no blemish sacrifice unto the Lord. And that's what you're doing when you pretty much continuing on in your wickedness, man. You know, the Lord is saying that you're for the Lord. No, you're not. No, you're not. You can't just, because that's what Christians do. They just say that, oh, I repent, you know, or Jesus is my savior. No, asshole. Repenting is not doing what you weren't once doing, you know. It says, verse 4, I also will choose their delusions and will bring their fears upon them. So when you choose to continue on in iniquity, Slack, I don't know if these brothers stream just went. Slack, you brothers here? Can you hear me, brothers? Yeah, this is Satan. It's probably finna get rubbed up anyway. Can you brothers hear me? You can't hear me? Yeah, this is wild. This is Satan. This is Satan right here. Y'all know I'm going to wrap it up because I can't hear nothing. Okay, I'm going to wrap it up. Yeah. If any viewers are still viewing, can you save the audio still? Can you hear the audio? If any viewers are viewing. Yeah, shalom. Like, yeah, I don't know. That was Satan, boy.
You can hear us?
Yeah, I can hear you, brothers. Now, y'all can hear me.
Yeah, Khan.
Okay, Khan. Yeah, I'm gonna just read this last precept. You know, this also in Isaiah 66:4 it says, "I also will choose their delusions and will bring their fears upon them." Why? Because if you refuse to turn away from your wickedness and continue on in, well, the Lord is gonna choose your delusion. He's gonna bring your fears upon you. You know, why? Because when I called, none did answer. When I speak, they did not hear, but they did evil before my eyes and chose that in which I delighted not. You refuse to repent, man. So the Lord is going to bring your worst fears upon you, man. You know, like I was saying earlier, one of my worst fears is water, man. You know, I don't want to fucking drown to death, man. You know, or I don't want no wild beast to run up on me. You know what I'm saying? And stump me out or like claw me out here, you know. But guess what? That'll happen to me if I don't continue on in the way of Yahweh Shimei Shai. He's going to bring those fears upon me, you know? It says, Khan, I'm going to read verse 5. It says, hear the word of the Lord, Yahweh Shimei Shai, ye that tremble at his word. Your brethren that hated you, they cast you out for my name's sake. Said, let the Lord, Yahweh Shimei Shai, be glorified, but he shall appear to your joy. And they shall be ashamed. That's what's going to happen out here, man. You know, those who repent and turn to Yahweh Shimei Shai, stay on the path, you know, they're going to be okay. But those who don't, you know, they're going to be ashamed and destroyed, you know. Yeah. You brothers got anything else?
Yeah.
Nah.
I just want to know how, you know what I mean? Scripture says that the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, not